Let's enter capital gains and losses listed on 1099B on the broker statement into FreeTaxUSA and TurboTax. It lists detailed information on securities and properties sold, such as stocks, bonds, etc. Form 1099B has detailed dates of sales and acquisitions, if available, selling price and original purchase price, or otherwise called cost basis amount. When you enter Form 1099B into tax software, it creates Schedule D, where all the gains and losses are recorded. Again, in TurboTax, you will be upgraded from the free version to the 129 premium version for adding the sold investments. Most software has an option to enter transactions one at a time, but if you have more than 3 to 4, you also have an option to enter a summary of all the transactions. When you do that, all you have to do is enter the short-term and long-term totals from the broker statement summary section. Notice two lines for the short and long-term totals, ones that have bases reported to the IRS and ones where bases are not reported to the IRS. What does that mean? Bases reported to the IRS means that the broker has electronically reported your purchase price to the IRS. If it says that it doesn't report the bases, it means that the broker didn't send that information to the IRS, or that the security was acquired prior to 2011 when it was not mandatory to do so. Let's start with the short-term covered transactions where bases have been reported to the IRS. List the sales proceeds from the summary section and what was the purchase price for these securities. If you have a zero or incorrect cost basis, check that you are making an adjustment and include supporting documentation with your filing. Another frequently listed item are wash sale adjustments, which means that the investor sold the security at a loss and then within 30 days before or after the sale, purchased the same or substantially similar security. If a wash sale is listed, it means that the loss is disallowed as a deduction on the original sale. However, the loss will be added to the cost basis of the newly purchased security. So in our case, the difference between the cost basis and sale price is a loss of $1,131.08. However, you can see that the net realized loss is only $941.33 because the $189.75 of wash sale loss is disallowed. Once we finish the short-term transactions, we will select to enter another cell and provide information for the long-term securities that are not covered. After we are about to finalize, we get a message that we need to upload our 1099B because we are reporting the sales section totals and either made an adjustment or cost bases are not reported to the IRS. In TurboTax, if you say you will upload it later, it won't let you complete the return until you fix that. At this point in TurboTax, we get a summary for all of our capital gains thus far. And it is a great news for Jane that her $3,154 of capital gains is not taxable as she is at the 0% bracket for capital gains. Thanks so much for watching.